My name is Chunka Ogomo, and I came to Canada in 2009. I'm originally from Cameroon, and I moved to Canada from Germany, where I was having further studies in environmental and resource management. I'm part of Northmount Baptist Church, and I'm the vice chair for the Deacon Committee for the church. I've been blessed with a beautiful family. I got two boys and a girl, and we currently live at Sage here in the northwest of Calgary with my wife. I've been a member of the Northmount Baptist Church since 2010, that is 10 years. And the reason that I volunteer is I'm trying to follow the footsteps of Christ. Christ, and if we go back to the New Testament, you will see the good works and that Jesus did. And those are examples that he had set for us to continue doing, even in his absence. So a lot of people will say that their volunteering with the church has actually gone down because of the pandemic, but it's different for me. Because professionally, I'm a health and safety guy for my company. And with the pandemic coming up, I've been involved in putting up a lot of guidelines in order to control or avoid transmission of this virus to other people. So I have used that expertise to come up with guidelines for the church. So I have become more involved in the church even than before because of the outbreak of this pandemic. Protocols are new things that are brought for people to follow. And we very well know that people are adamant to change. And such changes, for it to work well, has to be strictly followed. But I get really frustrated when some people don't follow this protocol. But the way that I approach issues like this is to try to educate the people on the reality about like the pandemic that is going on, and explaining to trying to make them understand why these protocols are in place. And the moment that they get things straight up into their mind because of a lot of mix-up that is going up in the media, these things need to be clarified to them. The moment they get it straight in their mind, everyone is able to follow this protocol. So the biggest to get buy-in from everyone is just to make everyone understand what is going on and how this can be prevented. It's very, very unfortunate that leadership in some countries, like the United States, are putting out information that doesn't meet scientific standards. Research have shown that the use of masks prevents transmission of this virus. And personally, I think that the use of masks would reduce the risk of you picking up the virus. So I encourage everyone who is going out there, or who is coming to church, or who has to go to the shop, to put on mask. It doesn't matter if it is the N95, if it's a surgical mask, or it is the one that is made of linen or the regular cloth. So it's always good to put on a mask, because it has been proven also that the virus is transmitted through droplets, mostly when people talk, when people exchange dialogue with one another. So by putting off a mask, it protects you highest from contracting this virus. As a Christian, we should be looking after one another. And I believe that by putting on this mask, taking care of our health and safety, encouraging our other congregants or other church family members to make sure that they stay safe, you know, gives us that sense of looking after one another, and then takes away that risk of anybody picking up an infection or getting sick of this pandemic or losing their life. So I encourage everyone to look after one another and make sure that everyone's health and safety is number one priority. I've been part of this congregation for 10 years now, and I already miss that sense of family that we all used to have, you know, sitting in the fellowship after the church service, fellowshipping together, talking to one another, conversing, you know, asking about kids and all that, seeing the kids running around. I really miss that aspect of the church. I'm encouraging everyone who is willing to come back, who is able to come back to church, because we have guidelines that we've put in place, which everyone will have to follow for their safety. So if everyone can follow these guidelines strictly, then we can guarantee that nobody will come here and live with the virus. If anybody comes here with the virus, it will be guaranteed that that person will live with that virus without transmitting it to some other person. And anybody who comes here without being infected will not be infected in any way. The two basic assumptions that we have when creating those guidelines is that if you get infected and you come to church, you would leave without infecting any person. The next one is everyone should assume that they are infected, so that, and they should not want to infect any other person. So if everyone can have these two basic assumptions in them and follow the guidelines, that will guarantee that anybody who comes to church will live in the same state that they came to church. So a lot of people keep questioning what is going on in the world today. I want to seize this opportunity to encourage everyone not to give up, to trust in the Lord, and to also know that the Lord knows that this is going on. And the most we can do is continue to trust in the Lord and pray. We need to pray more now. We don't know if it's a test that the Lord is sending, or it's coming out from the devil. So the most we can do now is just to pray and continue to trust in the Lord. And as He has let us know, everything will be okay. It's just a matter of time.